Thank God it's Friday, Eastern Football League lovers, and welcome to another edition, a special edition, in fact, of the Friday preview this week, always brought to you by Inside Football, the must read for the fair dinkum footy fan, available on your iPhones and iPads also. My name is Ben Warren-Smith. We've headed out to EFL House today because everyone's excited about the big clash tomorrow between Noble Park and Borwin. And joining me out here in the offices this afternoon is Father Time himself, Ray Baird. Good afternoon to you, mate.
Good afternoon to you, Benny, and can't wait for tomorrow's game.
It's going to be good weather, it's going to be a big crowd, and more importantly, it's going to be a crackerjack game. Also swanning into the EFL's studio house, whichever way you want to call it this afternoon, is a man we heard on the huddle for the first time this year on Wednesday night, and he's just come on in to have a little bit of a say today on the Friday preview. His name is Paul Hooper, and it's a very good afternoon to you, Hoops.
And good afternoon, Benny, and this is the, without doubt, the biggest home and away game of the year in Division 1.
It's going to be huge. Huge, isn't it? It's the Beyond Blue Cup out there tomorrow at Pat Wright Senior Oval. Both teams have had good seasons to date. Noble Park getting a couple of good wins over recent weeks. Borwin, well, they've gone undefeated thus far and sit atop of the ladder. Ray Baird, who is going to win and why?
Well, look, as you said, Ben, the standalone game, first versus second, what a clash we're going to see. Look, Noble Park, they're coming off a 45-point win over South Croydon. That was a game that they didn't have all their own way, and they're up against Borwin, who accounted for Norwood to the tune of 22 points, and that was a low-scoring affair. Borwin have been well-serviced by the ever-reliable Alan Murray, also Ryan McMahon, Jeff Goebbels, Jaden Hogle and Shane Tregear, and the inclusion this year of Taylor Gilchrist has certainly added another dimension to their game. Having said that, the injury to captain Rennie Gilchrist will be a major setback for them. Noble Park, on the other hand, are sitting second on the ladder and are starting to gain a fair bit of momentum after dropping a home game to Vermont in round 4, something they rarely do. Georgie Angelopoulos has certainly stepped up a cog this season, and the inclusion of big man Brett Dorr, a big mobile ruckman, has certainly given them the first use at the clearances. Shane Allen is back again kicking goals after an injury, and Sam Monaghan, Bo Cosson and Luke McGowan have been prime movers. This game will have everything, but I believe that Noble Park at home will certainly get the points.
Have you gone crazy, Ray Baird, tipping against a side who have gone undefeated so far this season? You mentioned one player out of that side who won't be lining up tomorrow afternoon. He is an important one in Rennie Gilchrist, but you're taking something away from the Tigers here.
BWS, I heard you quote on the huddle on Wednesday night that you believed that Borwin were going to go through the season undefeated. I don't know what you're on, mate, but I don't need any of that. I think that this is going to be a setback for Borwin. I predicted Noble Park to win the flag pre-season, and I'm sticking by that. And as my boy told me, never pick against Noble Park at the Bullring.
Yeah, well, he did just that very thing only a fortnight ago, and he's still hearing about it today. But, well, Hoops, you've joined us for the discussion this afternoon, and it, obviously, as you said, it's the biggest game for the year. Well, nearly, besides the grand final, of course, and other big finals. Where do you see this game going? Is it expected to be a close one?
I actually think that Bourne will win and win well. I think they're good enough. They've had the pickups of, as we said, Taylor Gilchrist, and coming across was Jaden Hogle as well. There's been a bit of a live wire at Bourne as well. I think they know how to recruit. I like their style of footy, and I think they'll actually have a win. I think they'll do it easily, four or five goals.
The home ground advantage at Noble Park has been a main player for them for a long, long time now, and this year they've dropped one at home, but they've been decent in all other games. Will that play to their favour tomorrow, do you think? Will that make it harder for Bourne? I know you picked Bourne, but will that actually make it harder for Bourne to get up tomorrow? The crowd factor, the home ground factor, or even just the whole spotlight being out there at Noble Park?
I think if Bourne get away to a good start and they can maintain a lead, they will run out easy winners. But if it's tight in the last quarter, that crowd there could obviously really assist Noble Park.
It's been a fantastic game for a number of years. The Beyond Blue Cup, head out to Pat Wright Senior Oval, otherwise known as the Bullring. Tomorrow afternoon, it's going to be a terrific day. Huge crowd expected and broadcast live on 98.1 Radio Eastern and streamed on the internet. EFL.org.au, the Australia's number one sporting site. We've been the Friday preview for another day. It was a quick and easy one, gentlemen. Thanks, Hoops. You came all this way, but you did a good job anyway.
I love it. Love being here.
And we love having you, mate. And Ray, you'll just always be here, but we love having you here too, mate.
Some people might think I'm sleeping here the way I'm on here all the time.
Got his old bunker in the back room. But the Friday preview's done for another week. Brought to you, as always, by Inside Football, the must-have read for the Van Dinkum footy fan, available on all smartphones and tablets. Gentlemen, we're done. It's beer o'clock. We're heading out to the football tomorrow. And as a wise man once said,
stick a fork in the sled.
We're done.